Hi YouTube, and thank you for clicking on this video. So if you are new here, my name is Ari. I'm a licensed esthetician, and on this channel I talk about skincare and I review skincare and make videos about beauty and makeup. So if you're into that, then make sure you subscribe before you go. But specifically today, I am going to be talking about The Ordinary's Hyaluronic Acid Serum. So I feel like the brand The Ordinary kind of took the skincare world by storm, just because we were used to kind of being told that if you want good, high quality ingredients, you have to pay a lot of money for them, which in a lot of cases still holds true. But The Ordinary came out and the prices were super affordable, and they also had really good quality, potent ingredients. So specifically today, I'm going to be talking about their Hyaluronic Acid Serum, kind of going a little bit into hyaluronic acid and basically my feelings about this product. So if you are into that and you would like to see my opinion, then keep watching. Hyaluronic acid is an ingredient that's used to bind water to cells, and it holds 1,000 times its weight in water. So it's found mostly naturally produced by the body in the skin, but you can also find it in your eyes and in the joints. But of course, when we see it made in skincare products, that part of it is made in a lab. This ingredient is amazing for all skin types, but specifically if you're dry and sensitive, this is something that you're going to want to add into your skincare routine at least daily. Honestly, I say at least daily, but you could literally bathe in this stuff and your skin would be perfectly fine. Now, specifically with The Ordinary's Hyaluronic Acid Serum, the first thing that I really liked about this product when I was checking out the ingredient list was that the first ingredient is water, which of course is the first ingredient in almost everything. But then the second ingredient was sodium hyaluronate. So if you've watched my videos before, you know that I'm very big on the potency of ingredients in a product when that's what they're advertising it to be. So of course, on the ingredients list, it's listed in the order from what's in it the most to what's in it the least. So you have water and then you have sodium hyaluronate. So right there, that basically tells me that the product is backing its claims, because there's a lot of sodium hyaluronate in here. So it's going to do what the packaging says. Sodium hyaluronate is hyaluronic acid, but it's a smaller molecular size. So that basically means that when you're using this, it's able to absorb really, really deep into your skin because it's such a small ingredient. And that's in its molecular size, of course, not in its potency. Another thing that I really liked about this product is it has glycerin in it. So glycerin is also a hydrating protective ingredient for the skin, but glycerin, the actual molecular size of it is bigger. So you have really small, really big. Those two ingredients work really well together for hydration because it's so much of what your skin needs into one product. So there was actually another ingredient here that I looked at. I'm not even going to try to pronounce it. I'm just going to put it on the screen right here so that I don't totally butcher this word. But basically, I had to look into it because I wasn't sure what it was. But basically, this ingredient just stimulates cell turnover and increases circulation in the skin so that the hyaluronic acid can work better. So one thing that I really like about products, and that'll definitely sell me on a product, is you have your ingredients that are kind of like the star of the show. This is what they're marketed to be. You have those ingredients, but then you have other ingredients in it that encourage those to work and help support your skin health and support the ingredients in the product to work better. So basically, that is what this is, and I really like that about this specific hyaluronic acid serum compared to other ones. And speaking of ingredients that I can't pronounce, I'm going to put another one right here. Again, this ingredient, and I wanted to talk about it specifically because it has the word sodium in it. And of course, sodium, we think of salt, like you think of, that's not something you want in skincare. But no, this is not salt. This is basically just an ingredient to encourage the preservatives to work. So the thing about preservatives is, I know with skincare, a lot of us want to be more natural. We don't want to put like anything toxic or bad on our face. But the thing about preservatives is, when you're using skincare with ingredients, ingredients go bad. And that's just, no matter what it is, that's how it happens. And ingredients are meant to be packaged because of shelf life. So you don't want a product that's necessarily too natural, because if you use something that's too natural, it can go bad. That can grow bacteria, fungus, things like that in the product, and then you put it on your face. So don't be scared of preservatives, honestly. Of course, some are better than others. If you're unsure of something, just Google the ingredient, look it up on a toxicity scale. That'll tell you right there if it's something you want to be putting into your body or something that you don't. But this ingredient right there is low on the toxicity scale, so it's basically at the bottom of that green zone, which means it's not toxic at all. And again, it's just going to help the preservatives to make sure that the money you spend on the product, it doesn't end up going bad in like a couple of weeks. Another ingredient in this product is pentylene glycol, which is basically a humectant. So when something is a humectant, it means that it's helping to hold everything together, because when you're making a skincare product, there's all different kinds of ingredients. They have all different properties to them. Some of them are more stable than others. So when you add ingredients like this, like a humectant, it's just going to make sure that everything comes together nicely, that it doesn't separate in the bottle. So the thing about glycols is there's actually three other types of glycol in this product. Some people are sensitive to them. We don't know why. We don't know why some skin reacts differently than others when it comes to them. But a lot of people use products with glycols in them their entire life and have no problems. Some people are very allergic to it. Honestly, it just depends on your skin. But if you've never had any type of issue with it before, you're perfectly fine. And honestly, most people that do have issues with it, it's an actual allergy and not an issue with the ingredient itself, if that makes sense. So if you're kind of concerned about reading the ingredients on this, wondering what's what, that's basically what the glycols are to hold everything together. In general, with the ingredients of the product, just doing a little bit of research on them, they're all in the green zone on a toxicity scale. So there's nothing in here that should kind of scare you, worry you, things like that, especially if you're trying to have like a cleaner skincare routine. You don't want to put anything bad on your face. This is paraben-free, sulfate-free, kind of those things that you want to stay away from. But either way, all of the ingredients in here are non-toxic. Overall, I think this is a really good hyaluronic acid like hydrating serum. So I haven't talked about The Ordinary before on my channel. I'd really like to research their products more to give you my opinion on them. But just from what I learned about this product, honestly, it seems really nice and really well-rounded. I enjoy that the sodium hyaluronate is so high up in the potency in the product. And I think that the ingredients that are hydrating in it have a lot of other ingredients to help support them, make it a nice, stable, hydrating product. So I really like it for that reason. Also, the price is super affordable, which is nice, especially if you're just getting into skincare and you're kind of unsure of what kind of additives to buy, things like that. Like if you're already using a cleanser and a moisturizer, but you want to add in some more serums and treatments to your skin, I think this is a really good place to start. If you were to purchase this particular product, you would use it after you cleanse your face and then before you put your moisturizer on. I was really pleasantly surprised when I read into this product, and I hope that if you use it too and you're enjoying it, definitely comment down below, and also comment down below any other products from the brand The Ordinary that you use, things you've liked, things you've disliked, just because I'm curious to see how you guys feel about it. But as an esthetician, I like this product. I would recommend it to someone. I'd recommend it to a client or a friend. So if you've used it, like I said, comment down below. Let me know how you're liking it. And that is it. Thank you so much for watching. If there are any other products you want me to talk about, let me know, and I'd be happy to make more videos for you guys. Other than that, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.